Hello. Welcome back to my channel. I'm Steph, and today we're gonna do an unhaul. So in July, at the end of July, I moved 6 hours away from my hometown, and I, prior to that, had most of my stuff in storage. So for 2 years, I've had probably over 100 books in storage that I haven't seen. And then over that 2 years, I also collected a bunch of books. So during this move, I decided that I wanted to try to really whittle down the amount of books I have, because as you can see, I still have a lot, and there's like stacks of books here and stacks of books here. It's a lot. So let's just jump into it, because this will probably take a while. I'm not gonna do all of the books, because some of them I unhauled and they were just from school that I kept thinking that I would maybe want to read them, but God knows I don't want to read any dead white men anymore, okay? So I'm gonna try to do this in some sort of order, but So the first book I have is House of Leaves. I have no interest in this, to be honest. I don't really know what it's about. Somebody gave this to me. I work at a library, and somebody gave it to me, so it's pretty tore up, but that doesn't bother me. What bothers me is that this is wild. And I'm sure it's really good, and a lot of people love this book. A lot of people say on the back it says it's funny, moving, sexy, beautifully told, an elaborate engagement with the shape and meaning of narrative. I'm too stupid for this. Next one I'm unhauling is Jacoby, because I tried to listen to this on audiobook and I didn't know what in the world was happening. I really like Sherlock Holmes retellings, or anything that is in that vein. I don't read a lot of thrillers and mysteries, but if it's Sherlock Holmes detective type, I will try to pick it up and read it, which is what this is inspired by, but it's set in like a fantasy-esque type world. So I think it was that they had fairies and creatures that only certain people can see, I believe. I don't know. I started it without really knowing that, because I don't read synopsis very much, which sometimes is a detriment to me and my book hoarding issue. So this one just wasn't for me, and if I ever get the urge to read it again, I'll just get it from the library. And that's kind of my rule of thumb here, is that there are some series that I'm getting rid of because I've lost interest, or I kind of bought it a long time ago and haven't gotten to it. So I feel like if I really wanted to get to it, I would have, and if I'm going to at any point in the future, I'll get it from the library. So that being said, another series, it's one is the start of one series, and the next one is a spinoff series, and I'll explain how that happened. So it's Cinda Williams Chima's book, The Demon King, which I've heard really great things, but I bought this years ago and I still haven't read it. And then, I don't know if you guys know, before Book Outlet was canceled and the worst company, they've probably always been the worst company, but they have a Boxing Day sale, and this was on sale. I didn't realize that you pretty much had to read this to understand what was going on here, and I might be wrong, but that's what I have been told. I just haven't gotten around to these. I truly don't know what they're about, and I don't need them. Another series that falls into that vein of like, if I find that I'm interested in it randomly, I'll just get it from the library, but I don't need it on my shelves because I bought it so long ago, is Wolf by Wolf and Blood for Blood, which in theory these sound really cool, but I did read one of Ryan's other books and I can't remember the name of it, and I DNF'd it, so it doesn't make me that enthusiastic about this. And to be fair, I actually won these from the library, so I don't feel that bad about giving them back to the library. And one of the last series that kind of falls into that vein of like, if I do find myself interested in it again, I will get it from the library, is the Winner's Curse trilogy. What's funny is I read Midnight Lie, which is also by Marie Rakowski, and it's supposedly set in the same world as the Winner's Curse. So I became interested again in reading this, and then at the beginning of quarantine, when I finished that book, I was like, yeah, I'm gonna read these. And I did end up getting them from the library because they were available. And I still haven't read them. So the next two are, I'm actually getting rid of because I have multiple copies of them. So The Wrath and the Dawn, when I went to Comic-Con, I won a copy of this and I already had a copy. I actually think it's right there. So I have a copy of it already and I don't need to have another one. Name of the Wind, also I have a copy down there. It's a long story why I have another copy, so I'm getting rid of this one. And then also when I was at Comic-Con, I won an ARC with The Wrath and the Dawn, and it was The Queen Assassin, and I didn't even know this was coming out, and I'm not that interested in it. So again, if some reason I have interest in this, I'll get it from the library. And then I'm also getting rid of The Assassin's Apprentice just because I did read this earlier in the year and I liked it. I just don't love mass market paperback. It's kind of just harder to read. So I want to try to find a better version of it, and I do plan on continuing this series, but I just don't want this copy. Also forgot, I won this at a Comic-Con giveaway as well, and I, again, don't really want a mass market paperback, and I haven't had a lot of interest in this series in general. If I have interest in it, I'll get it from the library. The motto of the day. The next three are ones that I read, enjoyed, but I'll never reread. The first one is Vengeance Road, which I really enjoyed. I was surprised that I liked it. It's a Western, and it's also a, like it says, Vengeance Road, it's a revenge story. I really liked this. I tried to read the second one, which I think is Retribution Rails, and I couldn't get into it at the time. I still kind of want to read it. I don't own that one. The next one is Queen of Geeks. I read this. I enjoyed it. I will never reread it, but I'm glad that I did read it. And I read Simon versus the Homo Sapiens Agenda. It was good. I enjoy the movie, but I have come to realize that I don't really want to read male-male romances written by females anymore, although I think this is really the only one that I have read like that, maybe? This next one is The Lies of Lacamora. I do want to read this. I'm a little skeptical because I've heard some things about the author, but again, this is actually mass market. If you haven't caught on, I don't really enjoy mass market paperbacks, so I would rather give them away to people who do enjoy reading these types of books. I don't know if they make bigger sizes, and I still need to figure out what's going on with this author before I commit to reading this. So the next few I have not read, but I kind of lost interest in them, is the Archive Duology by V.E. Schwab. I read the back the other day, actually, and I was like, sounds cool, I guess, but I'm good. And then Reign of the Fallen, I don't know. I just lost so much interest in this. It's another one of those, like, if I ever get interest back in it, I will get it from the library, which is funny because I was really excited for this. But the next two are This Savage Song and Our Dark Duet. I read these, enjoyed them, but the more I think about it, I'm not going to reread these. It's probably my least favorite V.E. Schwab series that I've read. Yeah, they're fine. The next one is Prodigy, and for this one, I read Legend earlier this year, and I could not tell you for the life of me what even happened in that first book, so I have no desire to move on with the series at all, which is disappointing because I really, really want to like Marie Lu, and so far, I've read the first one in The Young Elites, and then the first one in this series, and I'm slowly losing hope, but I still have two more books that I'm gonna try out. Pray for me. The next series that I'm getting rid of is the first series and a spin-off series, but they basically all go together. And that's the I don't even know what this is actually all called, but the Ignite Me trilogy, and then the, I don't know, Restore Me trilogy. So basically, if you don't know, the Ignite, or I don't even think it's Ignite Me, it's Shatter Me. The Shatter Me series was a trilogy about Juliet, and it was pretty good. It's like kind of, those books are kind of like candy where you just eat them and you know they're not like the best, but they're really fun and addictive. And then actually I read Restore Me, which is the first in the spinoff, and I really, really liked this one. And I liked the other ones. I know what they are, but this one, you started to dive more into the actual world, and a world was being built, and you were getting a background story, and so I had so much hope. And then the rest of the trilogy just went downhill. Like, I would say I probably rated this 5 stars. I'm pretty sure I rated it 5 stars. And then the next one was Defy Me, and I literally read it right before I went to the LA Times Festival of Books and met her, and it was such a disappointing book. It was like a 3, it was 3 stars, which in theory is not a disappointing book. I think 3 stars is a good rating, but it was disappointing for the fact that I like loved the first one and thought we were gonna get so much more. So I was a little nervous for the last one, rightfully so, because I feel like this one was like a 2.5. Not even gonna talk about it. I know what these books are. I know what they are. I know what they are. So here's the thing. I actually got rid of a lot of these books a while ago. Somehow I ended up with these two still. I think I know the reason behind it. But basically, it's Tower of John and Kingdom of Ash. So I think that the reason that I have those is because I wanted to reread Queen of Shadows, the one right before this one. I'm pretty sure it is. I was gonna reread Queen of Shadows and then read this and read the last one. And it was around the time that Kingdom of Ash came out. And to be fair, I liked the first two Throne of Glass books, and then the third one was good, and then the fourth one, it just became a lot, and I was like forgetting who. No, Empire of Storm is that one. I don't know, there's too many. By the time I got to Empire of Storm and I was listening to it, I didn't know what was happening. So I think I convinced myself that I would get rid of the other ones and keep these ones because I was gonna see it through and finish this series. I'm not gonna see it through. I'm not gonna finish this series. I don't wanna read any more of her young adult series. I just don't. If I read the spinoff of the ACOTAR, send help. The next couple of series, I guess, are by the same author, but different series. I'm getting rid of this. Here's the thing. I really actually loved Illuminae. I got halfway through Gemina and I don't want to finish it. It took me forever to get through it, and it's written in a way where it shouldn't take me forever. If you're not familiar with these books, which they're all over BookTube, so you're probably familiar, but they're written in like file format. I just can't do it. I'm also getting rid of Lifelike and Nevernight. I have read Nevernight. I have not read Lifelike. That's like, I read like a quarter of it and I hated it. And then Nevernight, I enjoyed it. Couldn't tell you what happened. I also don't know that I really love Jay Kristoff's writing that much. I do think he's funny at times. I just don't know that I like him. And then the last two books are probably one of the more, besides like Throne of Glass, are probably one of the more popular series I've seen on here, and that's The Cruel Prince and what's this, The Wicked King. I don't know what to tell you. I liked The Wicked King. I probably could have given this like a 2 stars. I will, you know, I say that, but I do have Queen of Nothing over here, and I'm keeping it just in case. But that doesn't make sense to the rest of what's happening here, where I'm like, I can get it from the library. I don't know. I don't make sense. I'm not here to make sense. So that's my unhaul. There's a ton more that I unhauled, but like I said, they were like school books and a lot of the Harry Potter stuff. So that's pretty much what I'm unhauling. Let me know if you think that I'm crazy for getting rid of some of these books. If you've read some of these books and you are convinced that I need to read them, it's probably not going to stop me from getting rid of them, but it could mean that I get them from the library. Anyways, I'll see you guys next week, maybe. And please like and subscribe, and talk to me in the comments. I love talking to people.